Get ready to match the stars. Edward Asner, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Chris Stewart, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers!
Thank you for joining us, because without you, where would we be? Now, this familiar face comes to us from The Young and Restless. Another CBS luminary is Edward Asner from The Mary Tyler Moore Show. How is your familiar face?
Falling.
Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Ruth Sherwin and Cal Wood.
Yay!
Hello, hello.
Ruth had a big day, didn't she? She went all the way. She won the exact amount of money she could want, you know, $5,600, right? And what are you going to do with that kind of money, Ruth?
Oh, I don't know. I've got three children in college still, so I think
that would probably help. Yeah, it really does help. And Cal Wood here, who's young and restless and single, as he pointed out so clearly the other day, and he so far has had no takers. But if he wins a couple thousand, $5,000, $10,000, you're... Post office box will be flooded with requests there. Now, he's ahead here, 2-0, but that's because she hasn't had her first round question, mainly. And we'll see how this game progresses after we see about this. Hurry back. Oh, we're on. Here we are. We're on. The camera's on and everything. All right, I'll push a button and reveal the other question here in our round one. Ruth, this is yours. Listen carefully. The supermarket manager fired all the checkers. Because instead of them waiting on the customers, the checkers were blanking each other. Oh, the checkers were blanking each other.
What's sweetheart?
Oh, you didn't hear a word I said, did you?
Yes, you did. You said the supermarket manager fired all the checkers because the checkers, instead of waiting on the customers, were blanking each other.
That's exactly what I said. Hey. And I thought you weren't listening.
I was alert and alive in a way.
Yes. Well, now do it. Now that you understand do it.
The checkers were... Oh, I got it.
You got it?
Sure.
Okay, that's it. Here we go. Andiamo, Charles. Here we go, Ruth Sherwin. The supermarket manager fired all the checkers because instead of them waiting on the customers, the checkers were blanking each other.
Were checking each other?
Checking each other. The checkers were checking each other. I'm going to check you out.
Well, I would tend to agree with Ruth because checking is a very active verb.
Checking, right. This one for Ruth. What did you say?
I have it. Tiki Dawson did tell me that I did lie. I missed one answer all week. But I'm holding my own. Checking.
All right. Here's a Ruth. Charles?
I said blue stamping each other.
Blue stamping.
It wasn't a dance.
No.
I like it.
Some of those stores do give out stamps when you make a purchase. Is that right, Trish? Right. What did you say here?
I thought checking was kind of obvious.
Really?
Oh,
so what'd
yes.
you do? Did you do the unobvious?
So I said checking.
Oh, you said checking. There is another answer that crossed my mind.
Yeah, but you can't say that.
Yes, you could. Sure you could. What did you say?
Kissing.
Kissing! Instead of waiting on the customers, the checkers were kissing each other.
Time just flew away.
Yes, it was a short day. What do you say?
Checking out.
Checking out. There's another one there. Sure. Well, now, you could do that, Patty. Since you know, instead the checkers. There'd be a little play on words here. I'm sure this is what the writers must have thought about when they wrote the question.
Oh.
The checkers, you know, the game of checkers.
Jumping.
Yes, instead of the checkers were jumping each other instead of... So there'd be nothing wrong with that if they were playing checkers.
Oh.
You'll get it in the parking lot later, though. Okay, here we go. Round two coming up. Cal Wood, what do you say?
I'll take A again, please.
You want A? Let's see. You've matched two. You've matched Charles and Richard. The rest of you do this, please.
Howard Cosell said, "Today, I cannot venture out of my house because the laundry has blinked my toupee. That is why I cannot... The laundry has blinked my toupee."
Does that question make sense?
Yes, Howard Cosell said that. "I cannot venture out of the house because the laundry has blanked my toupee."
It does make sense.
It does make sense.
Sure.
Well, nothing here makes sense.
Well, I meant, like, a sense in that you have something to say.
No long discussion. Just put a word in the blank.
A blank there.
A blank in the blank.
The blank. Yeah.
That's very good. Very good.
Yes.
Very good. The laundry has blanked my toupee. Shh. Leave her alone, Charles.
Leave her alone.
Okay. Cal. Howard Cosell said, "Today, I can't..." He said it in many more words. We're short, giving you the short version. "Today, I cannot venture out of my house because the laundry has blanked my toupee."
Shrunk.
Shrunk my toupee.
Shrunk.
That's good.
I just got the question. Yeah.
You really are getting dumber as years go by.
Well, I've been very smart this week.
Yeah. Oh, this is an unusual week for you, Edward. What do you say there?
I say that instead of shrinking it, he still could have worn it since all they did was starch it.
Starch is good. Another good one?
You know, I finally realized what the definitive answer... If you had said the Chinese laundry, then yeah. I would have gotten the definitive...
You didn't understand the word laundry was in there?
Sure, but I didn't quite understand. You're going to hate me for this.
I hate
but
you.
Remember how wonderful I've been all week. I said wash.
Rotten. Absolutely rotten. Got to match the rest of them there, Ruth, to stay... I mean, Cal, to stay in the game.
I don't play.
You don't play.
There's a nurse in the wings to help you get through the rest of this performance. I will be in my dressing room.
Thank you. Do you play? Yes, you do. I can't venture out of my house. I'm so happy for all of us. Because the laundry has shrunk my toupee, and he's got to match you and Patty to stay in the game. What do you say there, Trish?
He starched the toupee, and here is a picture of a starched toupee.
That's a starched toupee. So that means Ruth wins another game. What do you have? Not starched. Congratulations once again. Okay. Cal, if any mail comes in, Cal, we'll forward it to you. All right?
Thank you.
He's a young, good-looking, steady worker and all that sort of thing, and reasonably well-educated, got a tricky mustache and a full head of hair, and some gifts for you from Match Game 76, Cal Wood. So long, old bean. While we're spinning him off, we're going to spin some of these messages just for you, then you hurry back. Ready? Here we go. Ruth Sherwood is up here for the second time. She's got $5,700, just picked up another $100. Now she's going to try for another $5,000 or more, and we'll see how she does. You ready?
I'm ready.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank bench, B-E-N-C-H, blank bench. Now, the answer that bunch gave most often is worth $500. You got to match it, however. If you match the middle one, you get $250, and then the bottom one gets you $100. Whom do you call on whom?
My friend Richard.
Johnny Bench.
Johnny Bench. Great baseball player.
Charles.
What do you say, Chuck?
Where you and Brett go when you can't get enough money for the motel in Encino, you go to the park bench.
Park bench. And Brett? How do you say, Brett?
What about the bench?
The bench?
Yes.
Well, as in the bench.
Judge. On the bench.
Judge's bench.
The bench. You mean referring to the judicial phrase. Yes. Okay. So you've got the bench, Johnny Bench, and park bench. You want one of those?
I'm a baseball fan, and I'll go with Johnny Bench.
Okay. Let's find out if that dead catcher Johnny Bench is up there, and if so, where? Let's begin at the bottom, Ruth, and reveal the $100 response. Park bench. All right. That's one that Charles gave you.
Thank you very much.
Sit down and shut up. We're looking for Johnny Bench. May we see the $250 number? Work bench. Oh, very interesting answer. You have that one?
A bunch of layabouts there are here.
Right. Last chance for Johnny Bench. Slide it. Sam. Jack. Johnny. You got it.
Congratulations. Very good. Now, you've gone along great. You picked up another 500, and you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or 5,000. Now, you feel lucky?
I sure
do. Feel ESP? You got a lot of ESP?
I sure do.
Who, with whom do you feel ESP-ish?
Richard.
With Richard. Oh. She says the ESP is flowing from her to you, Richard.
Okay.
All right, let's even get it flowing back to her with this. Worth $5,000, and it goes as follows now. No help from the audience, because you may give her a rotten answer. Blank over. O-V-E-R. Blank over. All right, he's finished. Ruth, what answer do you want to give us that'll match his?
Well, I can think of two, but I think I'll go with easy over.
That's over easy, isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'm sorry, we have to accept that as your answer. She was thinking of over easy, and she said easy over. And a most unlikely possibility that Richard would say that. But we'll turn to him anyway, because it's time to do that now, Richard.
We were thinking wrong, the right lines with food. I thought of an apple turnover.
Turnover. Turnover. Rollover is another good one.
Unrollover.
Got a fall
over. Fallover.
Yeah. Some good choices here, and you did not get together on it, but you did enrich yourself by $500 or $600. You got $6,200. And a new player, let's welcome Jerry Gay. Ready? Okay. All right, now, Jerry, we welcome you.
Thank you.
And we ask you to tell us where you're from and all that sort of thing, or anything you want to tell us.
I live in Huntington Beach. I have two daughters, Robin and Holly. I've been married almost 16 years.
Yeah.
Right now, I'm taking it easy for the summer, but I work part-time for my dad. He makes turquoise jewelry, carburetor parts, and cutting oil.
He's the Renaissance man.
Yes, all around.
Carburetor parts and turquoise jewelry. Mm-hmm. Fascinating. All right. Good luck to you. I take it that's some of his work,
yes,
right?
Yes, it is. Uh-huh.
That's very pretty.
Thank you.
All that stuff. Your fingers?
That's the carburetor part.
Oh, that's the carburetor part. I'd like to see your jewelry someday. Now, you have a choice here, Jerry, of A or B.
I'll go with B.
B. Okay. Here we go. Ready? Well, I'm not. Yes, I am. Stella said to her husband today, I stopped our car on a dime. Unfortunately, the dime was in a blank. Stopped our car on a dime. Unfortunately, the dime was in a blank. Got it?
This is definitely.
Think about that, Jerry. All right. Ready down here.
Cue answer.
Okay. We'll walk over here to Jerry Gay. Jerry, Stella said to her husband today, I stopped our car on a dime. Unfortunately, the dime was in a...
man's pocket.
In a man's pocket. Okay. I don't boo that. That's one possibility. That's one of the possibilities. What'd you say?
Well, I just said a pocket.
A pocket. That's it. One for her. Brett?
I said that it was in another car.
Another car.
Because okay. I was struck recently by some dumb broad who...
I don't want to hear about it. Charles?
I said a policeman's car.
A policeman's car. We're looking for a man's pocket. Trish, what do you offer?
Well, I thought of a manhole, and then I came up with a ditch.
A ditch. All right. What did you say, Richard?
What would a dime be doing in a ditch? Just a question. I don't have to answer.
I don't think I'm going to.
There is no answer to that.
No. Man's pocket.
A man's pocket. Jerry, two for you. Now, we come to Patty Deutsch, and do not have high hopes at this point, Jerry, because...
Oh, it's self-explanatory. A bus driver's changer.
A bus driver's changer. Yep. Okay. So you did pretty well with that. You picked up two, and that's not bad for a first-round question, is it? Not bad at all. Your first-rounder will come along later, but right now this for you. We are ready. Here we go. Second half of round one. Ready, Ruth?
Ready.
This is all yours. Everybody plays. Say, you know how when a pretty girl walks past a... by a construction site, you know, the way the workers throw kisses at her. Well, when ugly Edna walks by, the workers throw blank.
Throw blank?
Yes.
Just no S. Blank.
Well, do what you want. Don't ask questions. Just
don't ask questions?
Use...
Yes, sweetheart.
Use the brain that you have.
When's Baron Frankenstein coming?
Look, pretty little toofies you have.
Thank you.
Yes, nice. She, what do they throw?
Well, when a pretty girl walks by construction site, the workers throw kisses. Well, when an ugly Edna walks by, the workers throw blank.
Right. Gotcha.
Did you say something?
No.
Oh, all right.
I was just reveling in the size of her brain.
I got it.
All right, I will walk over here. Everybody's ready over there. Here we go. You know about this. When a pretty girl walks by a construction site, the workers throw kisses. Well, when ugly Edna walks by, the workers throw...
Rocks.
Rocks, she says. Okay? Rocks is what she says.
Well, I must say, Ruth, I don't usually see construction workers working with rocks. I usually see them working with bricks.
Bricks. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
Never mind the size of my brain. What about the size of his brain? Mine's big enough to match it.
Uh-huh. In advance, you're booing Chuck's answer? No. Remember, he's very tough.
I used to work on construction, Gene, both here and in the Connecticut Valley.
Yeah.
And I would throw a hot rivet.
A hot rivet. Throw a hot rivet. Okay, that's what he said, a hot rivet. What do you offer?
Well, poor ugly Edna. You know how most men tip their hats? Well, right. These throw their hard hats.
Throw hard hats. That's another good response. They threw their hard hats.
I said bricks.
Bricks. Yeah. Bricks and rocks. All right, so far it's 2-1. What do you say?
Up.
Throw up. That says it all. Okay. So there's round one. 2-1 the score. Favor the challenger. Jerry, you may have A or B.
I'll take B again.
B again? Edward, you do not play.
Uh-huh.
Richard, you do not play.
Edna the rest and of I you. Were the best.
Yeah, you were the best. One African native said to the other, he said, you better keep your dog on a leash. Yesterday he tried to blank the bone in my nose. Keep your dog on a leash. Yesterday he tried to blank the bone in my nose. Okay, you got the idea. One African native speaking to
we're
another.
We're going to get letters.
Oh, I don't care. Why do I?
Better answer, yes. I think.
Sure, you saw mine.
That's very good. Okay. Now we come over here to Jerry Gay. One African native said to the other, you better keep your dog on a leash. Yesterday he tried to blank the bone in my nose.
Tried to bite.
Bite the bone. You're groaning. Bite the bone in my nose. Well, Brett, you're up first. What do you say to that?
I'm sorry. I said he tried to bury the bone.
Bury. Oh, yeah. Good one. Very good, Brett.
Sure was a good one. She took it from me.
No, she didn't.
That's not true.
Don't fight children. Trish, she says, bite the bone in my nose.
Actually, I think they took it from me. It's bury the bone.
Bury the bone. All right, three of those so far. And Patty.
Reprise of Barry.
Reprise. So there's four of those Barrys and none of yours. Now, when we come back from this commercial, they have one to tie, two to win. So hurry back and see how this game turns out, if at all. Here we go. All right, Ruth, you ready for yours? This is it. One to tie, two to win. Dumbo the elephant said, I was destined to go into show business because of my unusual birth. You see, I was born in a blank. Dumbo the elephant is speaking. You don't like it.
That's right.
Dumbo the elephant said, I was destined to go into show business because of my unusual birth. You see, I was born in a blank. All right, here we go. Put it down, Edward, quickly.
All right.
Dumbo the elephant was destined to go into show business because of my unusual birth. You see, I was born in a...
I'm blank on it. I'll have to say circus.
Oh, you drew a blank on it.
I drew a blank.
Well, wait till you hear some answers here, and it'll give you an idea of what we're after. Edward?
Well, I might have said valise,
but
instead I said trunk.
See, Dumbo the elephant, trunk. That was all she couldn't think of. A Charles?
At the Princess Theater in Glockamana, Island.
Trunk. Aw. Okay, now, Trish.
Uh-huh. I said tent.
Tent.
Very good.
All right,
right
Ruth,
there, baby.
You've got to match Richard. No.
Trunk.
Trunk. And Patty said trunk. And so that means Jerry Gay wins the game. Congratulations. Come on down. All right, you stand by for a moment. Ruth, you're going to be leaving here with $6,200. Thank you very much. Bye. Bye. Lovely couple.